Everything changes. Sometimes that change is constant, sometimes it's exponential. Today, we're exploring sequences that have a constant change, arithmetic sequences. Like I just mentioned, arithmetic sequences are sequences that have the same difference between consecutive terms. For example, in this sequence over here, we're always adding 3. And arithmetic sequences can also have negative common differences like we see here. So in general, our arithmetic sequence notation is a1 for the first term, a2 second term, so on, and an is the nth term, where n is a variable. And we say that d is the common difference. So d, for example, would be a2 minus a1, a3 minus a2, so on. Okay. Nth term of an arithmetic sequence. So there's a cool little trick you can use. Let's say you know the first term, and you know the common difference. So what you can do is say that the nth term is just the first term plus n minus 1 times the common difference, which intuitively should make sense, because each time you go from one term to the next, you add the common difference, d. So you do that n minus 1 times, so you're just adding this to the first term. Right? It's just saying first term plus number of terms minus 1 times common difference. And we can also express it in terms of other terms of the arithmetic sequence. So, for example, the fifth term, let's say, or A4, let's say, is going to be 2D more than A2, because there's two differences in between A2 and A4. And that's what this is saying, basically. The nth term is the mth term plus the n minus m, where n minus m times the common difference. You just look at the number of terms in between, multiply by d, and add to the term previously. And also you can find the number of terms of an arithmetic sequence by looking at the last term minus the first term divided by the common difference plus 1. So for example, if our arithmetic sequence was this, you could find the number of terms, 13 minus the first term 1 over common difference 3 plus 1, which is 13 minus 1 by 3, that's 4, 4 plus 1, 5. And as you can see, there are indeed 5 terms. Okay, now here, the average of the terms in an arithmetic sequence is, of course, the sum of all the terms divided by the number of terms, but there's also a shorthand. It's just the first term plus the nth term divided by 2. So it's the average of the first and the last terms is a shortcut way to find the average. Right? And also, it's the average number of terms. If the number of terms in the arithmetic sequence is odd, the average is equal to the middle. And if the number of terms of the arithmetic sequence is even, the average of the arithmetic sequence is equal to the average of the middle two terms of the arithmetic sequence as well. And here's another very important formula. The sum of terms in the arithmetic sequence is the average of the terms times the number of the terms. That makes sense, right? Average times number equals sum. And the average, like from above, is just the first and last term sum divided by 2. And you can do some weird substitutions using this formula, but there's really no point in doing that if you just understand how sum is average times number and how to find average. Hey, cool. We're ready for our first example. Find the value of a2 plus a4 plus a6 plus all the way till a98 if a1, a2, a3 is an arithmetic sequence with common difference 1. And we have this quantity here. a1 plus a2 plus a3 all the way till a98 is 137. So common difference 1. That means that as you go from each term, the difference is 1, so a2 minus a1 is 1, a3 minus a2 is 1, a4 minus a3, 1. Okay, so we've got this weird expression, the sum of all terms. So you might be tempted to plug it into the sum of all terms formula. But always keep your eye on the ball. What are you actually looking for? Just this quantity right here. It's not the sum of every term, it's the sum of even terms. Interesting. So we have to somehow use this quantity over here to find this thing here. And how might we do that? Here's the trick. A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4. This is what we know, right? Plus A97 plus A98. That's 137. We know this as a fact. It's given. But we're trying to find the sum of basically half of these terms. So maybe we can express the sum of all of these terms. You know what? Let's call this a variable. We're trying to find this quantity. Let's call it x, okay? So x is a2 plus a4 plus dot 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 all the way till a98. That's x. Now, can we maybe find this expression in terms of x? Because if we can do that, then we can easily solve for x. So this is what we're trying to find. We're calling it x. And we can maybe make express this in terms of x, perhaps, maybe. So the key thing here is common difference 1. So what we can do is see that a1 is nothing but a2 minus 1. A2 minus 1 plus A2 plus A4 minus 1, sorry, A4 minus 1, the term, plus A4, so on, all the way till plus A98 minus 1 plus A98. That's 137. Okay, and we know, okay, so we know this, let's box them. We know the sum of all these blue terms over here is x. Oh, but wait, look, we've got the exact same thing, except, so that's also going to be x. Let's do it green. So all of these green terms also sum to x. So now we've got 2x, right? One from all the green terms and one from all the blue terms, right? Because each odd term can just be expressed as a, for example, a1 is a2 minus 1, a3 is a4 minus 1. So essentially, we can rewrite it in this form, and we've got 2x basically, but we've also got a bunch of minus 1 terms that we have to account for. So every odd term, a of odd, equals a of odd plus 1, right, minus 1. That's essentially what we have, because the common difference is 1. Okay, so that means that for every odd term, we also have to subtract 1. So minus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus dot dot dot. However many odd terms there are. And from 1 to 98, there's going to be 49 odd terms. So we have to subtract 1 49 times, or it's the same thing as just subtracting 49. Right? And this is equal to 137. Let's recap. So far, we found that A2, A4, A98, that sum was x. And we found that all of these odd terms have a sum of x. The sum of all the even terms is just x. And the odd sum was x minus 49 because each odd term is just the even term minus 1. So we just had all of these even terms again and then also minus 1 49 times. Then we found the total sum in terms of x to get this equation. And now we just solve 2x equal to 186. So x equals 93. So that indeed means that 93 is just going to be our answer here. Let's solve another interesting arithmetic sequence problem. The sum of the first five terms of an arithmetic sequence is 65. The sum of the first 10 terms of the sequence is 255. Find the sum of the 15 terms of the arithmetic sequence. Okay, you've got a bunch of sums. So you know what we probably want to use? We should probably be using the sum of all terms in an arithmetic sequence formula. Remember, sum is average times number of terms. And we don't know what our sequence is. We don't know what it is. We just know that it's an arithmetic sequence. So the best strategy here would be to assign variables. So So what we can do is say, let's see, the first term is a, then a plus d, then a plus 2d, then so on, where the nth term, remember, is a plus n minus 1 times d. Okay? So, okay, we've got this expression for the terms of an arithmetic sequence. We've got, but the thing is, we need to now find the sums. Let's express each of these sums using our formula, right? Let's see. So sum of first five terms. First five terms equal to first term, which is a, and the fifth term. The fifth term is a plus 4d, right? Because it's the first term plus four differences between the first and the fifth term. And this is the average times the number of terms is 5. This is 65. Similarly, first 10 terms is a plus 90 divided by 2 times 10, and this is 255. Okay, looks like here we've got two equations, two variables. That's a simple two-variable equation which we know how to solve from previous videos. Okay, interesting. And look at what we're trying to find here. We're trying to find the sum of the first 15 terms of the sequence. The sum of the first 15 terms of the sequence, that's going to be the average of the... Oh, sorry, looks like I'm blocking here. Whoops. Let's move out of the way. So over there, we found that the sum of the first 10 terms was the first term a plus the 10th term a plus 9d divided by 2 times 10, the number of terms, equals that sum given in the problem to be 255, right? Okay, and now this is the information we do have. So now the natural thing to do would be to solve these equations. Let's multiply by 2 to both sides of both equations to get, this will become 130, this will become 510. From the second equation, we divide by 10 from both sides. From the first equation, we divide by 5 to both sides. We end up with these simple equations. 2a plus 4d equals 26. 2a plus 90 equals 51. And now we can clearly see that the easiest method would just be to subtract this equation from the second equation. Let's move that. So the easiest solution would just be to do this to get 5d equals 51 minus 26 equals 25. So d is 5. Cool. And now we can substitute it into any of the equations to solve for a. So we can maybe do this one. 2a plus 9d, which is 45, equals 51. 2a equals 6. A equals 3, so 3, A equals 3, D equals 5. So the sum of the first 15 terms of a sequence is just going to be A, let's see, sum of first 15 terms. That's the first term, A, plus the 15th term, which is A plus 14D. Because 15 term is the first term plus 14 differences divided by 2, that's the average of the first and 15th terms times 15. Now all we need to do is evaluate this expression over here. Interesting. So now we've already solved for a and d. All we really need to do from here is plug it in. And that shouldn't be too hard, right? This is equal to 3 plus 14d, which is 70, over 2 times 15. This top part is 76 by 2 times 15 equals 38 times 15 equals, well, here's a neat little trick you can do. 38 times 10, 380. 38 times 5 is half of 380, 190. The sum is 570. That's our answer. Ignore that. So 570 will be our answer to this question. And to quickly summarize all the steps, first we used the nth term formula, sum of first five terms, of the first 10 terms we expressed in terms of A and D, we solved the two variable equation and then plugged it into this expression to find the sum of the first 15 terms. And now here's some cool special series that are worth remembering. The sum of all the numbers, 1, 2, 3, till n, is n times n plus 1 divided by 2. That's a special arithmetic sequence, and that's definitely worth remembering. The sum of the first n odd numbers is n squared, right? So for example, the sum of the first 4 odd numbers is 16. And you can do that by just seeing, oh, it's 4, the first 4 odd numbers, so it's just 4 squared. A cool little shortcut you can use. And some of the first n even numbers, so for example, we have 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10. That's 5 terms, so just 5 times 6, 30. So that's n times n plus 1, as you can see over here. And here are some other formulas you can see. They're not as important for the AMC 8, but they're still can be good to know. Sum of first n squares and n cubes. You can look at them here or in the Mastering AMC 8 book down below if you're interested. Okay, now we're going to move on to geometric sequences. And this one, these sequences have a constant ratio between their terms. The ratio, instead of adding, now you're multiplying. And let's explore that in the video right there.